You know, when this book came our way, I thought, so yes, excited. This is Lee Castledine's jam. This is so you. And then as I read it, I thought, no, this might be, you're so hardcore, this might actually be not right for you.
Yeah, well, I thought the same. I thought, ah, oh, this probably book isn't for me. It's more for sedentary people who don't really move all that much. And then I started reading it, and then I started trying a few exercises, and I went, oh, maybe this book is for me.
So this is about building your body for life. It's not about growing giant muscles or being the fittest human on the planet, but it's about mobility for your life. And it's absolutely fascinating because they give you all of these insights in what you can do. So let's, this is like the main, they give you lots of diagrams, right? And this is the main exercise they say that you should be able to do.
So this is like exercise number one.
One.
So if you can't get through this one, and so I'm just gonna show you.
So cross your leg. Now you can put your foot on the ground. You're being hard on yourself. You're supposed to be able to sit down and sit on the floor and then don't even get yourself back up.
Jiminy.
I can hear you now.
Oh, it's cracking. It's cramping. I'm good.
So that is a sign of someone, like, you're incredibly fit, right? And that's a sign you're supposed to be able to get down and sit and then see if you can get up and how many touches, times you need to touch.
Yeah.
And what we should also be doing is sitting on stools, because we all sit every day in these chairs that are like 90 degrees, and that's not the way our bodies are built to be all the time. Sitting on a stool changes your angle. They tell us you should actually sit on the floor every day for like 45 minutes or so, because that gives your body, it's different, it's where your joints are, where your limbs are, and how your body can move.
Yep, this book is written by Kelly and Juliet Starrett. Now, these guys have been in the fitness and they were those hardcore type people. They owned one of the very first CrossFit in the world. So if
they were world rafting champions. Yeah, they were full on.
They met through that as well. So they've been through that phase in their life. So they've built something here, literally built something for everybody. And I know where actually I'm lacking, and that's in my mobility and flexibility. So I got found out. But this book is about everything. It's about nutrition, it's about health, it's about sleep, it's about balance.
Yeah, and they have 10 vital, durable, and for lifelong practices. So some of the things they talk about are really simple. They have 10 vital signs and practices that they give you, and they're called mobilizations. So they don't call them exercises. It's actually mobilizing your body. So what you just did, or nearly did.
Thank you.
But that's incredible to me, because you're like the fittest person I know, and that's a really hard thing, but that's because your body is so tight. Yes. So mobilizing your body is good. And part of this is about, as you get older, the main reason people pass as they get older is because they fall. Yep. So this is doing things like standing on one leg when you brush your teeth and then close your eyes, and it's really hard.
We tried it before, didn't we? Nearly fell over.
Yeah, we did.
You know, and as I said, there's 10 easy steps. Not easy steps, They're not easy. 10 steps that sort of you've got to master, and if you can master all of them, you're well on the way to living a really sort of lengthy and sort of durable life as well. So, you know, what I loved about this was that the reason why they wrote this is because I think with the internet craze of fitness influencers out there, there is so much information and everyone's getting so confused, so they just really needed to simplify something.
Yeah,
you
I
agree with that? Like, absolutely. Every time I scroll through my internet, I'm getting a new theory every single day, new studies, new scientists saying this.
Dr. Michael Mosley, the BBC and you know, British doctor who does lots of things on health and diet, has a book called Just One Thing, and it's a combination of all he's done, but quite a lot of the things he's saying are in this book as well. Things like standing on one leg when you brush your teeth, just little things that you can do in your everyday life so it doesn't take over your life, but they actually help your life. Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. And as I said, it's not only for the people who are looking to get started, it's also for the people like myself who are quite active and quite fit, who think they are but think, yeah, I've got this covered, I know what I'm doing, and all of a sudden, as we saw before, we just get found out a little bit and go, hang on a sec, maybe Lee, you need to work on a bit more mobility and flexibility rather than the pipes.
And they're saying it's not just
pipes,
don't give them up, don't give them up. But that's what they're saying, like, don't not do your run, and don't not do your two Pilates classes a day, whatever it is that you do, but that one thing mightn't just be enough for you. It's about all the other. So they give you, there's plenty of diagrams, and they go through the simple vital signs. I wouldn't say it's all easy. Like, some of these are really challenging.
Yeah.
And I don't think you'd be a champion if you can incorporate all of them into your life.
Yep.
You probably would be right with this. But I loved that it was quite challenging, even for someone who's uber fit, but actually some of these things might be healthy for you long-term, because you could stop breaking yourself, because you break yourself a lot.
Do I? Mm. Yeah. I do.
So Lee, what you could do is get moving, get mobile, and get in store.
Actually, don't hop online. Go into the store, walk.
Stand on one leg, buy a book. That'll work.
That'll work, yeah. Do that.
In between, sit on a stool. Or you could sit on a stool or on the floor online.
Just buy it. However you like.